Good morning, students. This is Professor Kiran Poddar, Angadi Institute of Technology and Management. Today, we'll discuss exponential probability distribution. Exponential probability distribution is a continuation of continuous probability distribution. Exponential comes under continuous probability distribution, where the things will be considered as measurable. Before going through the example, first let us understand what is exponential probability distribution. As we all know, in a previous class we discussed a continuous probability distribution. There we understood what is continuous probability distribution. If the continuous probability distribution satisfies two conditions, one is f of x must be greater than or equal to 0, and integration of f of x between minus infinity to plus infinity must be equal to 1. So this is the condition. If this condition satisfied, then we can say it is a continuous probability distribution. Therefore, if you see this definition of continuous probability distribution, we'll understand the things. So continuous probability distribution is a distribution where the function f of x will be greater than or equal to 0, and the integration of that function between minus infinity to plus infinity must be equal to 1. Then we can say this distribution is continuous probability distribution, or even we call it as probability density function. So this is all about continuous probability distribution. Then what is the meaning of exponential distribution? Exponential distribution is like this. The continuous probability distribution having the probability density function f of x, and the f of x is given something like this. This is alpha into e raised to minus alpha x for x greater than or equal to 0. Means what? Suppose if you take a graph here, so it is something like this, where this is x equal to 0 and this side it is infinity and this side it is minus infinity. If x is more than 0 means what? From here to next up to infinity, here the value will be alpha into e raised to minus alpha x. The functional value will be this. Other than this means what? Where x is less than 0. Less than 0 means this side. So here the functional value will be 0. So this is the condition. Means exponential probability distribution works between 0 to infinity. X is equal to 0 to infinity means positive side of x. There it is called as exponential distribution. Whether this exponential distribution is really a continuous probability distribution or not. What is continuous probability distribution? Where f of x must be greater than or equal to 0, and integration of that f of x between minus infinity to plus infinity must be equal to 1. So in this we can see f of x will be greater than 0, because if you put a minimum value of x equal to 0 also, then we are going to get alpha. So alpha is greater than or equal to 0. It is given in a definition itself. So f of x is greater than 0. Then integration of that f of x, if you put, and we know that between minus infinity to 0, the functional value will be 0. And from 0 to infinity, the functional value will be this. Alpha into e raised to minus alpha x. If you take alpha common, and integration of e raised to minus alpha x with respect to x will be e raised to minus alpha x divided by minus alpha between 0 to infinity. So alpha get cancelled, then minus is taken out, then e raised to, substitute upper and lower limit, then it becomes e raised to minus infinity minus e raised to 0. And we all know e raised to minus infinity is equal to 0, and e raised to 0 is equal to 1. So minus of minus is equal to plus 1. Therefore, integration of f of x with respect to x between minus infinity to plus infinity is equal to 1. Therefore, both the conditions of continuous functions, continuous distribution are satisfied by exponential distribution. Therefore, the exponential distribution is known as probability density function or continuous probability density function. Then mean and standard deviation of exponential distributions are like this. mean mu will be taken as 1 by alpha, where alpha is positive. Variance sigma square will be taken as 1 by alpha square. And standard deviation is square root of a variance, that is 1 by alpha. But very clearly we understood one part here. That is, mean is also 1 by alpha and standard deviation is also 1 by alpha. Therefore, mean and standard deviations in exponential distributions are equal. They are same. Means whatever mean we get, that itself is a standard deviation. For example, in any of the example, if it is asked, find the mean and standard deviation of a given example. Then if you find out the mean, if you come to know what is the mean of that standard given example, that itself will be a standard deviation. This is very clear. Okay. So let us go through the examples now. In example, it is something like, if x is an exponential distribution with mean 3, find probability of x greater than 1 and x less than 3. And we all understood the concept of exponential distribution. It is like this. So x is equal to 0, this side it is infinity, and this side it is minus infinity. So we know that from here to here only it will be alpha into e raised to minus alpha x. So this side it will be 0. And what calculation we are taking? We are taking where x is greater than 1. Means here there will be a benchmark. So we are going to calculate from x is greater than 1 from here. And x is less than 3 means we are fixing the boundary 3 here. Means less than 3 means 0 to 3. Okay. This is very clear instruction that we need to follow. Okay. Very first, we all know in this probability distribution, it is a continuous probability distribution. Therefore, the probability density function of this exponential distribution is given by f of x is equal to alpha into e raised to minus alpha x, where x lies between 0 to infinity, and other than this 0 to infinity condition, it will be 0, equal to 0. And the mean mu is nothing but 1 by alpha. Okay, then from data, is mean given? Yes. They mentioned mean is equal to 3. Therefore, from the given data, we have mean is equal to 3, which is nothing but 1 by alpha. Okay. So, 1 by alpha is given, mean is given, that is 3, that is nothing but 1 by alpha as per the exponential distribution. Therefore, alpha is equal to 1 by 3. So, we got the value of mean. So, alpha is equal to 1 by 3, we come to know. Then if I ask what is the standard deviation for this, 1 by 3 only, because we know that mean and standard deviation in exponential probability distribution will remain same. Okay. Therefore, this f of x becomes f of x is equal to, when alpha is equal to 1 by 3, then it becomes 1 by 3 into e raised to minus x divided by 3, where x is greater than 0, and other than this it will be 0. Fine. Therefore, first question. What is that? Find probability of x greater than 1. So, probability of x greater than 1 need to be calculated. Probability of x greater than 1 means what? From 1 to infinity. So, it becomes very large in calculation part. For that, what I do, we'll take its reverse implication, that is, probability of x greater than 1 is nothing but 1 minus probability of x less than or equal to 1. Okay. So, this is equal to what? 1 minus probability of x less than or equal to 1 means what? If I take this as 1, then less than or equal to means what? From 0 to this part. Okay. We are going to calculate. So, that can be calculated through integration here, because it is a continuous probability distribution. So, it becomes integration between 0 to 1, 0 to 1 f of x dx. Fine. So, which is nothing but 1 minus integration between 0 to 1. Then what is f of x? When we are fixing the things between 0 to 1, here f of x is alpha into e raised to minus alpha x. And alpha is nothing but 1 by 3. Therefore, this becomes a function, that is 1 divided by 3 into e raised to minus x divided by 3 with respect to x. Therefore, 1 minus 1 divided by 3 will be taken common, then integration of e raised to minus x by 3 is nothing but e raised to minus x divided by 3 divided by minus 1 divided by 3. Fine. Between the limit 0 to 1. Here 1 by 3 get cancelled. Therefore it becomes 1 minus of minus plus into integration of, e raised to minus x by 3 between the limit 0 to 1. If you substitute upper limit as 1, then it becomes e raised to minus 1 by 3. Minus. If you substitute lower limit as 0 in place of x, it becomes e raised to 0. Therefore, probability of x greater than 1 is equal to 1 plus e raised to minus 1 by 3. 1 plus e raised to minus 1 by 3 minus e raised to 0, that is nothing but 1. Therefore, it is nothing but e raised to minus 1 by 3. Plus 1, minus 1, gone. Therefore, e raised to minus 1 by 3. In Calci, if you type e raised to minus 1 by 3, then we will be getting its answer. Okay. So, e raised to minus 1 divided by 3. That is equal to 0.7165. Okay. So, this is the probability of x greater than 1. Okay. So, probability of x greater than 1 is what? 71.65% of the time. Similarly, second question. What is second question? Probability of x less than 3. Calculation of probability of x less than 3 means what? Less than 3 means, as per the graph it is, if I take this is 3, less than 3 means what? Between 0 to 3. Therefore, directly we can go through integration. Integration between 0 to 3, f of x dx. And between 0 to 3, the functional value will be what? Alpha into e raised to minus alpha x. But alpha is nothing but again 1 by 3. Therefore, this will be the function. That is 1 divided by 3 into e raised to minus x divided by 3 with respect to x. Therefore, again, let us take 1 divided by 3 common. Then what is the integration of e raised to minus x by 3? That is e raised to minus x divided by 3 divided by minus 1 by 3 between 0 to 3. Okay. So again 1 by 3 get cancelled. That is minus into. Substitute upper and lower limit. Then it becomes e raised to minus 3 by 3 minus e raised to 0. So which is nothing but minus e raised to minus 1. 3 get cancelled. Then minus of minus plus e raised to 0 is 1. Okay. Therefore, substitute the value. It becomes 1 minus 1 divided by e. If you put it in a, type it in a Calci, then you will get its answer. That is 1 minus 1 divided by e raised to 1. Okay. So that is equal to 0.6321. Therefore, probability of x less than 3 is equal to 0.6321. So this is the answer. Means 63.21 times there is a chance of getting probability of x less than 3. Thank you.